Hello friends, welcome back. In our previous videos, we have been talking about a lot of technical stuff like BERT or GPU acceleration or Markov chains and all. So today what we are going to talk is a little different on the track. We are going to talk how you, when you build a solution, how you take it to your customer, whether your customer is going to accept it or not, what you have to show to your customer. So this specific video series may not be that much of interesting for those Python developers or junior machine learning developers. It will be more interesting for the people who are into the consultant roles or architect roles, or who are entrepreneurs and having AI machine learning products, or even for the freelancers. So before I start with the theory, let me give you a quick glance what we are going to cover in this two video series. We are going to talk little about a project lifecycle and what this video fits into this lifecycle. We are going to take one customer problem and we'll talk about customer queries. We'll tell you how you cover the due diligence and feasibility study, how you identify the complexity and the cost, and we'll, using a Pareto chart, we'll try to see where this which solution is better. Also, in the next video, I'll show you this calculator, how to make it. This calculator may be different for your specific problem, but ultimately all these things look like same, how you are going to actually come to a cost and how you are going to derive this year and year. So let's talk about a typical AI project lifecycle. In any AI project, first you understand the customer problem. Then for that specific problem, you find out what would be the best solution. You do the estimation, you do the planning, and after that you get into the proper development, where you first gather the data. You do the data preparation like feature engineering, metrics. You decide what will be the accurate metric for deciding whether the result is good or not. Then you go ahead and train your model based on your pre-processed data. You test it, tune it, deploy it, and then in the production you validate the results and then support it. If there is anything wrong over a period of time, then you validate. What you do is you go back, fine-tune your results, and then you go back to this cycle, right? So today's objective is we are going to talk about this specific estimation and planning area, which generally gets untouched by other videos which normally talk about the algorithms and all. Let's take a customer problem. It can be a chatbot, or it can be a invoice based OA solution, or it can be an NLP based solution, image based solution, or it can be audio based solution. It can be anything, right? So let's pick one of the case where a customer is looking for a solution, an AI solution, which can scan his invoices and return data in structured format, right? So what he is actually looking for is this kind of solution. This is a loan agreement form. This is a Google's solution. So what he is looking for is he wants to extract this data that is coming in his invoice or loan agreement form. These are the fields, whether marital status, married or not, what is the phone number. So this data he wants into this kind of area, which you can put it into an Excel or into a database, which can be further. Maybe he has a use case where he wants to call all the people who have filled in this form using this phone number that they have filled in. He want to give it. So rather than somebody manually extracting this phone number and typing it somewhere, AI solution can extract it and directly send to the telecallers, which can further make a call to them. Right? Or an automated solution can actually send the SMS also. So what are the common customer queries for this specific requirement or the concerns that he may have? First thing he's going to ask, what your company or you, say you have X company, or suppose you are a consultant, then what solution you are going to provide to him? What would be the cost of the solution? He is of course going to ask, because he has to shell the money from his pocket, right? Then he would like to compare it with other available solutions which are already there in market, because you are not the alone, right, who is going to build any AI solution. There are plenty of other people who are building the solution and they already proven. And then compliance is another question. This is just a small set for the demonstration I have made. You may need to add more questions to this based on your the problem and the solution. after you understood the query, customer problem, what you will do is you will say that it is an invoice based OCR solution, right? And then you are going to do a due diligence or the feasibility study of with the customer. During this feasibility study, the objective will be to find out what will be the cost of development, customization, deployment and overall run, and year on year what will be the benefit. To read this objective, you actually are going to create a set of questionnaires, a long set of questionnaires that generally prepare. For the simplicity, I have listed down some of the questions. Because this is an invoice based OCR solution, the questions can be whether he has any challenge in using this cloud based solution, Azure, Google, or he just wants to go for the on-prem solution like Tesseract or OpenCV, or he is good or happy with the Azure at Google or API, etc. If he has any preference, then he can suggest there. Per page, how many invoices in these invoices, how many pages will be there? For example, if we see here, there is just one page. This will help in deciding the complexity of the final solution and the cost. Total number of fields. Here the fields, how many are there? There are, I think, 20-30 fields are there. Then customer should provide this. In your chatbot, you may ask how many queries user is going to ask, what kind of question user can ask. In invoice based solution, if whether these are handwritten or printed, as you can see, these are all printed numbers. Suppose you want to claim an invoice, claim a insurance, then probably you will like to write, as a customer will like to write his name, phone number, etc. Then these will become handwritten documents. Handwritten documents are generally difficult to parse and accuracy is low. So you should ask this question. In case of your chatbot, probably you may ask for the domain and other question. These questions are based on the customer problem and the solution. And whether year on year, is there any increase in the load is going to happen. This question you may ask, but I will not cover this in our simple calculator that I'm going to show today. Okay. Based on your data, that customer that has given you in the previous due diligence phase, you will put that into this calculator, right? That calculator I'll show you how we make it. So you feed this data into this calculator, your calculator is going to tell you how much complexity is there. Based on, by seeing this complexity, it can be a simple, medium or complex kind of calculation. You can define the brackets. These are generally easy to by help of these simple, medium, complex classification, you can actually convince the customer better, like this is a high complex or this is a medium complex solution, the cost may be higher or not. But this is the deck, this is the PPT that generally you are going to present to the customer. You generally show that, okay, your solution may be medium complex, and based on the medium, this medium complexity, your run cost and the one-time cost will be this. So we have taken three solution here: Azure, Google, and a on-prem solution. And on-prem, maybe I told you, suppose you are going to use the Tesseract or OpenCV. We are not going to talk much technical about these solutions. I'll show you how. Now the customer of course is going to ask this question, okay, what will be the one-time cost, how much I need to throw from my pocket. So you will say, if you are going to use Azure based solution that we will offer you, you just have to pay us around $2,970 as just one time for the customization. For the Google also same, but if you are going to, for an on-prem solution, you are going to spend $6,000 from your pocket one time. Very expensive, right? Almost double. But during the run cost, you will have to spend $1,100 per year. Every year you need to spend based on the number of document that you are going to send to Azure, because they charge daily, right? Same, Google is little more expensive here, 1.4k you are going to ask from the customer every month. But in the on-prem will become cheaper there, 316. The customer will get confused, which one should I choose? This is double, but this is very less. So to solve this confusion of the customer, you are going to tell that if you are going for Azure based solution, then your on-prem solution will become cheaper in the fourth year. And if you are going for Google based solution, then your on-prem solution will become cheaper in the third year. Now suppose customer has any bias towards any of this vendor, say suppose he says, no, I'm a Microsoft shop, I'll only go for Microsoft products, then you can say okay, then in after 4 years it will become cheaper, your on-prem solution will become cheaper, whichever you want to go. Or suppose he say, no, I want to go for the Google, then probably by seeing this, suppose he get convinced, okay, let's go ahead and take the on-prem solution because this is becoming cheaper in the third year itself. Right. It depends upon how much contract they are going to make with you and what their plan. So this is something that you are going to show to your customer, and with the help of this, customer would be able to decide which solution is going to pick. Now what is the base? How I'm showing all these cost, right? I've come to this cost, or how this chart is being prepared, that all this is there into this Excel. I have made it specifically for you to explain this. I'll explain it in the next video. Okay, so stay tuned. Thanks.